What I can offer you is, I will personally bring Miguel right over to your television studio as soon as he's done with the concert. Well, as quickly as we possibly can. Listen, I'll only let him do one encore. How about that? Yes. No, now, I realize that you're dealing with a live show, and we are dealing with variables here, so the bottom line is, if you want Miguel on your television show, you're going to have to be flexible with the time slot.
Later is better in this case.
Yes. I understand. Yes, and we appreciate you making an exception this time for us. You will not be sorry, because Miguel is amazing.
See that?
Okay.
You're amazing.
You're a very objective source.
Okay. No, thank you. Bye-bye. Ah-ha! What is better than a successful business negotiation?
It ranks right up there. They're okay with the time situation?
No, they're not okay with it. But they're willing to work around it because they want you so badly. You are so easy to sell.
Well, come here. I want you to look at something, okay?
Oh, good. What?
For the video.
Yeah?
What do you think?
I think this one.
Yeah?
Yeah.
That is a good answer. Don't you just love synchronicity?
Yay!
Hi! It's my hubby. Hi. I didn't know my hubby was here. Hello, hubby.
Hello, wifey.
What's this? Oh, costumes for the video.
Yeah, yeah. Would you like to have a vote?
I can?
Sure you can.
Yeah, well, she's feeling benevolent today.
Wrong answer, but
it's a
nice try.
Hurry, hang on.
Fine.
No, you don't have to do this.
No. What am I doing?
You're pretending you're not hurting. We're all friends here, Brenda.
I know that. Look, I don't know what I'd do without you guys right now, or without work. I don't even know what to do with myself right now. I don't know where I'm supposed to live. I don't know how I'm supposed to live without him.
Brenda, you know that you could stay here as long as you need to.
Thanks. You two just got married and everything. I don't want you tripping over me every time you leave the bedroom.
So we won't leave the bedroom. Look, Lois is right. You're more than welcome here.
It means a lot to me for you guys to offer that. But I can't.
Okay, well, there's always the main house. You can bask in the glory of Quartermain life once again, such as it is. I'm sure Grandmother would just love to have you there.
Yeah, and then I'll have to bump into AJ and Jason around every corner and they'll say I told you so. I think I'll skip that pleasure.
Why don't you get a place of your own? I mean, you can't afford it.
Yeah, I guess that's what I'll do. It's just...
What? It's just what, honey?
It's just I just don't want to get lonely, you know?
Well, I have an idea. It's simple and it's going to solve the problem. Why don't you come with me?
Oh, no, I can't really go anywhere right now, Miguel. I mean, I have to stay here and take care of all the New York concert stuff. I mean, we don't have that much time left, you know? I really have to do that.
Well, excuse me, but there's time to get you settled, right, Lois?
Yeah, absolutely. Come here, come here. Yes, yes. Go. Fly. Come on. Go ahead.
Let's go.
Do you see how fragile she is? You know, we gotta keep her running as fast as she can, or I'm telling you, she's gonna snap like a twig. Trust me, Ned. I know this place. Brenda's got that same haunted look in her eyes that I had after I found out about you and Catherine. You have no idea how close I came to losing it more than once, so I know from where I speak. The best thing that we can do for Brenda is keep her running so fast she doesn't have time to stop and realize how miserable she is.
Damn Sonny Corinto. I knew he'd hurt her. And I tried to warn her. I tried to warn both of you.
Please don't start with the I told you so.
I just want that man out of our lives.
So? To what end, huh? We don't have anything on him that we could prove.
Mac's gonna keep his eyes and his ears open, and so are we. Let's hope
one of us stumbles across something that we can offer a judge so at least we can serve up a search warrant.
Can't help it, Ned. I hear the words coming out of your mouth. I know that what we're doing is right. But I just hate this down to my very core. I mean, Sonny was my friend.
Lois, a friend wouldn't do what he did to you. He used you for your record company to camouflage illegal activities. So forgive me if I can't muster up a sympathy vote. I want him gone.
Ah, well, hello, newlywed.
Lucy.
Hi. That's fine. Don't worry. I'm not going to stay. You don't have to be nice to me. I'm just sort of on a, what would you say, a mission. That's what I'm doing, and I've hit sort of this rhythm thing happening, and it's kind of a hit-and-run thing. Because if I realized what I was doing, I probably would realize it's a very difficult test, what I'm doing.
I'm sorry. I don't have a clue as to what you're doing or what you need.
That's okay. It's all right, because you wouldn't, unless you're clairvoyant. Oh. Well, what I'm doing is I am cleansing my aura of all the kind of dark, splotchy, messy, inky things that are stuck on it. And to do that, I have got to forgive everyone who has grievously wronged me. Wow. You know what? I'm beginning to realize I deserve a medal for all my strength and perseverance in the face of incredible odds. Because now that I come to think about it, practically everyone in this town has dumped on me at one time or another. That's not your problem, though, is it?
Nope, sure isn't.
Okay, to the business at hand. Ned, I forgive you for cheating me out of what was rightfully mine. That would be deception. And you did it knowing full well how hard I worked and the sacrifices I made to get that. And you also knew that you and Damien did not deserve that company. Nobody else deserved that company more than me. Okay, so I am a very aware kind of hip kind of gal, though. And I realize that you're not the same cold-blooded creep you were back then because of Lois here. And because Lois is the only other person in this town that I don't have to forgive for anything besides little Emily, I think that you being able to attract her speaks volumes of your spiritual growth. I'm done. I'm happy. I gotta go. Keep making those hit records. Stop. She kills me.
The mind does reel, doesn't it?
So, what's this about picking my brain?
I'm in the middle of a partnership situation over at L&B. I can use your input on how to proceed.
You know, I've never liked partnerships myself. Makes things unnecessarily sticky.
Oh, boy, did you just speak the truth. Maybe I should have come to you before I made a deal with the devil. But who knew, you know? I didn't know he was the devil. I thought he was my friend.
I take it we're on the subject of Sonny Corinthos.
Mr. Q, I got major problems with him.
Of course,
but I wouldn't listen. Because of our past history, you know? Mm. I mean, Sonny is like a part of my family. He and my brother Mark, they were running buddies. So I thought it was great that we were going into business together. Now it's just, it's blown up in my face. I don't want to lose my company, Mr. Q. Can you help me?
Well, if what you tell me is true, then your first priority should be distance, and as quickly as possible. There are such things as RICO statutes. Not to mention the possibility that he could be implicating you in any number of illegal activities without your knowledge.
No, I don't think he would do that.
Geez.
I don't, Miss... Look, as for the rest, I do agree with you, okay? The question is, how do I attain a lofty distance? Sonny refuses to agree to dissolve the partnership. And if I walk out on my contract, he says he's going to sue me from now until the middle of next year, and he ain't kidding.
Ned has our attorneys on this?
Yeah.
They're very thorough, and I have every confidence they'll be able to find a loophole in your contract that we can get around.
But what if there aren't any?
And we'll get you out by whatever means necessary. I don't want you to worry. You're a quartermain now, Lois. And no two-bit hood like Sonny Corinthos is going to force you into anything you don't want.